SEGA. Hello, this is the RPG Chick, and welcome to another game in my 2,000 subscriber special edition. It is another Genesis game, Shadow Dancer, the Secret of Shinobi. And now I can't say too much more because we're about to start a little history lesson from 1987. AD 1997, New York. New York City. Having vanquished the evil crime empire Neo-Zed, Shinobi was not heard from again. His combat ninja skills were not needed in a peaceful world. Aww. But a new threat arose in a reptilian form that lived on vicious instinct alone. The colossal monster moved slowly and quietly, and its attack was relentless. The souls unfortunate enough to live became hostages. Mass panic swept the streets. It remained only for Shinobi to take action, the ninja of the shadows. His weapons were stealth and quickness of attack, his only allies when facing overwhelming force. Relying on ninja weapons and magic, Shinobi fought on, assisted by his faithful dog. This is the story of their defiance, I think it is. Okay. Start button. Now this game, I don't remember when it came out, but it's, I liked the game before this too, which was either Shinobi 2 or 3, also on the Genesis. Pretty awesome. Now this game is, well, to many people this game is easy. To me, it's hard. It is a short game, but it's, in some ways it's kind of brutal, I find, in that one hit can kill you. In many instances. I'm gonna take type 3 here. Now, I'm not sure. I think this is hardness level. Easy. Let's do easy. I'm not gonna finish this game. These are background music. Sound effects. Hoo-yah! Anyway, so yeah, I'm going to be using save states to progress through because you do get continues, but you have to start the level over, which isn't that long, but you only get a certain amount of continues. So this is the kind of game that would kick my butt on the Genesis. Although I loved every minute of it. Road 1, burning downtown. Huh. Now, the thing I love about this game is you have a dog. And if your meter fills up, well, you can jump. You can lift shuriken. If you let that fill up, if the dog is currently barking, it will attack whatever it's barking at. Pretty much it barks whenever there's something on the screen. You can see. Look at that, it's barking. Okay. Hold on a second. Okay, I want to make sure you're still with me. Another game tried to, well, defragment my hard drive while I'm playing, and that's not very friendly. Well, so I'm still getting used to controls a little here. See, I'm hitting the wrong button for jump. So you're not going to see me die every time. That would be like as torturous as to you as it is to me. So let me do the torture and you guys can see the more of the success. Such as it is. This is the kind of game that would, you know. See, he doesn't see that enemy, so he won't. See how that guy just, like, does this dance down there? That's pretty awesome. Oh. waiting for that thing. There's a manhole down. So. Hold up. Cool thing about it is you can't hurt your dog. One more. Hooray. Yep, I just saved my state right there. Now the dog can be hurt. Let's see if I do this right. If not, you'll see how the dog can be hurt. Primed and ready. Cool. He can be hurt by the shields or whatever that is that he's throwing. Easiest way is to just pop up right next to an enemy like that and you can just hit him. Okay, now we got power up, which is always nice. Really not good at games like this. But I do the best I can. Whoa. Got a one up there. Ugh. They make you start over, but your enemies are gone. Or most of them, anyway. Hostages are gone. Oh. Well, somehow, if you jump, you'll get hurt by the rocks. Otherwise, they will one-shot you and kill you. So just jump up when that happens. Okay, gotcha. Ooh. Alright, now we got a boss level already, I think. This is annoying as hell. I'm pressing the button to jump, and I'm pressing the wrong button. Oh, crap. I'm terrible. Nope, dead. You hear me clicking away over here, but. Nope. So you got those game overs. Continues, rather. See, I wanted to jump, and I pressed the button to throw the shuriken. That's how I suck. I press the wrong button all the time. Constantly! Wrong button! Okay, jump, shuriken. Evade, stuff like that. Nope. Alright, I'm jumping too soon. Trying to go too quick. It actually isn't that hard. It's just, I'm not good at it. He plays this peekaboo thing. I'm not sure if this works. Hold on. Trying to... Yeah, okay. Saving. Not too bad. Bonus stage! Just shoot all the ninjas you can. Sometimes I think I actually get more if I just stand in one place and just continually hit the A button. Some of them just... don't want to be hit. So you can get 1-ups and extra points. 10,000 points bonus. So I don't think we get anything, like, any extra lives that time. I'm not sure, we might have to get all of them. Row 2, battle on the railway. Huh! Love this song. Oh! Oh no! I didn't even mean to jump down, actually. This is gonna be interesting. I'm not talking much, guys, because I'm in the zone here. So, Genesis was my... You gonna throw it or what? Genesis was my console. I love having the dog and the, you know... that ability that wipes out all your enemies. It's just... because the enemies are tough, so you need ways to kill them. As you see in the bottom left there, that's a tornado kind of ability, so... I've actually remapped that key completely. Because I kept pressing it by mistake, I've actually made the select key to be that power, so I don't hit it by mistake. Still gotta remember it's there, though. Now, the interesting thing is that even if you jump up... see, it's not affecting the enemy. Just think guys who jump all over the damn place. Sometimes I just can't stand them. Jump up there. As I mentioned in my little intro video for these Let's Revisit videos, my brother had actually... well, technically the Super Nintendo was his. Before that, the Nintendo was ours, everybody's, and the Atari 2600 before that was ours. I had the Sega Genesis. Sega Genesis games are a lot harder than the Super Nintendo games. Let's see, can I get these guys? Nope. Let's try again. There's gotta be a way. Ooh, I did it. Well, I kind of bumped into them that way. Alright. The exit's right here, I'll show you guys. Oh, he did it anyway. If an enemy harms your dog, it turns into this little puppy. It's so cute, and then he can't attack. Just gonna save here. Let's see, can we jump up? Oh, I can't get back over. It's not yet. Oh boy, I gotta take care of him first. Where's it gonna fall? Barely got anywhere, so. See, I'll show you. He gets hurt and turns into this little puppy. Isn't he so cute? See, now he can't. You can't. Yeah. Shit, you guys get it. Now he's back. Power up. What? What's going on here? Hold on. Oh, I have to go down? Okay, never mind. And I did it before and just couldn't figure it out this time. Go figure. Oh boy. Awesome. Can I get that? Awesome. Awesomes. All awesomes. Oh, wait. Oh, I knocked him off. Wait. That's not what I meant to do. There you go. Save again. So, yeah, I love the game, but I don't love Genesis games in general. We gotta jump and hit that. Ugh. See that one hit? I'm cutting out a lot of stuff. Because I keep dying. Got him! No, 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 no. It's too late when that happens. Gotta jump. Oh, I jumped on it. Twice. Three times a lady. I don't know if that helped that much. I'm not sure if they're effective against boss. Well, they are, right? Because I against that one, it worked. I just answered my own question, which I should have remembered anyway. Yay! Hurrah! Definitely saving that one. God, I don't know how they can evade like that. See that? That one guy is just like, I'm right here. You can't hit me. That's why they're ninjas, I guess. Another 10,000 points, right? How we could survive a fall like that? It's actually a really interesting level, the Statue of Liberty level. Station guy. Oh, I can't yeah, I thought I could stand there and it would go over me, but no, it doesn't work that way this time. That doesn't really work out either. Okay, get him, doggy! Nope! Got him. You gotta get him when the shield's on the way back. Hello, level. I don't know what the hell these mutant things are. I guess they're mutant things. Oh, well, I didn't even see that coming, obviously. Gotcha. No. Yeah, I can't get up that way. That's a death trap if I ever saw one. Oh, that's a death trap too. Oh. That guy with the gun is over there. I knew he was gonna. Hello and goodbye. The repetitive sections like that were. Ooh, I wanna get that. Mm-mm. Saving a lot because I hate playing this crap over and over again. Ugh. Not fair. Yep, I'm a cheating fool. Thank you. can't jump up there. Oh my god. Did I get... Oh, I'm running out of time. That's all we got. Sorry. It's fine by me. Fine by me. Huh. So I've been playing for a while. I really like this section. Well, it's tough. Especially when you press the wrong key and you want to jump and instead you're attacking. That comes back. Jump it. Oh, I can't. I was trying to save. Oh, I killed myself trying to save this. Save state. That's what I get. I like that you can attack them as they're one person, kind of. Makes it a bit easier. Saved. Bye bye. Kinda really, you can't. You can't really mess with the, what do you call it? Timer, because it. You have to go up to the top, right? Right. Oh my god, I'm just gonna die the same way. Well, then I'm gonna go all the way over here and do that. Ah, it's tough. Gotta be a trick to it. I just don't know the trick, obviously. Maybe just bounce off of them some more. Oh, the frickin'. Oh, God. You know, I've been doing this the wrong way. Whoop. Boss battle. Now I gotta jump over her frickin' thing. I'm not sure you're supposed to hit her. Like, hit her head. I think you have to get her when her head is bent over. Death. I'm not sure if you can damage her while you're jumping over it, so you might have to make two jumps? I'm not even sure. I did! I did get her. It is. She's down to 4 now. Oh boy. That was too close for comfort. Get her one more time. One more time. Bow, bow, bow. Nope. Every time she kills me. One more. If I kill her, do I even have to worry about the thing? Oh, I'm almost out of time. And I'm dead. Come on! I don't like hitting her from that way. Get me on the left side, thank you. Left side. Oh crap! Messing up my buttons again! I run out of time. Come on! I don't like being on this side. I'm gonna die. No! Left side! Left side! 15 seconds. Aha! Ha, ha. Jump on your corpse, your flaming corpse. Oof! All that time? Wow. Bonus stage! Almost done. I won't finish the game. I'm not gonna try to finish the game. Maybe in an alternate reality. This is just a look at it, you know. I've never finished this game. I mean, I suppose I could if I abuse save states some more, but I just wanted to show you guys one of the games that I used to play and used to make me rage and slam my hand into the TV screen. Don't think he says 7 at the end. Nah, it's 43, dude. Road 4, in the darkness. Yeah, never got past this level, or the next one. Oh, I guess they're gone. Righto. Don't jump! See what I mean? Why do I keep jumping into that? Do not jump into that. Get him, Lassie! Yeah, I had a feeling that would happen. Keep going. Oh, crap. Oh, no. Too many. Oh, no. No, no, no. Ah! Like a good spot here. Can I duck under that? He shot me. Frap started to mess me up for some reason. The game is completely starting to freeze on me. Bye-bye. Oh, and bye-bye. That's the jump button. That's hilarious. Where'd you go, doggy? Okay. Oh! Yeah. This is the stuff that just... I could not get past this crap. Yeah. I'm saving almost with every step here. Just stuff like that. That's the exit, though. I noticed. I've probably been passed here to the next screen, but I'm not even sure. If I have, it's not very often. Yeah, I've been here. You can't see the enemies when they're in there. The darkness. So sometimes they just stand there in the darkness. I don't know why I bothered doing that. Ah, crap. Crap. You can tell he's there somewhere. I don't even know where I am. Got him. Sometimes the time limit just runs out because it takes me too long to get through all these freaking people. Mm. Death trap! I'll show you guys what I want to do. This. I'm taking too long with this damn level. Where's that guy? Is there more than one? This might be the farthest I've ever gotten. Stage 4-3 start. Oh yeah, I've never fought this thing. How do I... what do I do? When do I... oh! Ooh! When do I hit it? Let's just save... here. I'm not gonna beat this thing, I'm just gonna try a few times. I've never fought this, I've never gotten this far. With the help of save states, you know. I think when it shoots the fireballs, then the heads are... look like they're vulnerable at that point, maybe? Oh! Oh! Gee, I don't know what to do about this thing. I'm guessing when it throws the fireballs, you hit, so you gotta jump the fireballs. Probably maybe you have to hit it when it turns red like that. Nah, that didn't even work. Yeah, I'm pretty much done. Thanks guys so much for watching. It's gonna be hell editing this video. I'm gonna edit out about 30 deaths at least. Oh wow, I hit my foot. It hit my little toe and killed me. There's gotta be a point, an area, and a time to hit it when it's... vulnerable without getting hit by fireballs. So I'm gonna play out the rest of this continue. And that'll be it for me. So this was me on the Sega Genesis going insane. I used to hook this up to my Amiga monitor so I'd get better, you know, better quality, a lot better quality with the games. I had an AB switch hooked up. So I used to switch between, you know, I used to use the same monitor for the Amiga computer and games like this in the Genesis. Lots of fun. Didn't get too much anywhere. I don't think I ever finished a Sega Genesis game. Oh, I did, actually. Dungeons and Dragons Warriors of the Eternal Sun was one of the first games I ever finished. Besides Pitfall 2, I was like, I can finish games! This is a Dungeons and Dragons game. Yeah, so thanks for watching. Tune back next time, well, for when I play another game. Gonna be doing some Amiga games next, or one or two Amiga games, we'll see what I can get working. Thanks for watching, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.